Money, 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 your weekly personal finance date with me, Surabhi Upadhyay. Now, retirement is something that we all think about, but how many of us are actually looking at planning for it realistically? And even when we do think of those silver years, do we build in outlier situations like maybe a health contingency, a family emergency of sorts? And some of these events can really drain our financial resources. Well, these are some of the issues that we will touch upon in today's show. And joining me is personal finance expert Kalpesh Ashar. Kalpesh, great to have you on the show as always. So it's an evergreen subject and we keep talking about it on Money, Money, Money because I think it's important to drill the importance of planning in the mind when it comes to retirement, right? You interact with clients across the board. Is there generally a better awareness? Are people looking at retirement planning in a more structured way now?
So, you know, this thing comes up time and again. And like what you said, it's an evergreen subject. So even professionally for us, it's always on the anvil that we look at people for their retirement. And it's a very crucial issue to be, you know, addressed in our country especially. Now, if you really look at the meaning of retirement, I tried doing that. It is one who has given up on his active professional life, his career, his business, his job due to age. And that word struck me that it's due to the age factor. And when we say age, people tend to, you know, have a very conventional thought when it comes to retirement, that once I retire, my health has to be, you know, looked up in a very simplistic manner. My thoughts have to be very simple. My day-to-day schedule has to be according to a certain time span. I cannot go haywire and so on and so forth. So everything becomes very conservative. And obviously, it reflects on your finances also.
Yeah.
So immediately, once a person who's stepped into the retirement mode, he becomes very conservative, looks at fixed income, becomes a bit risk averse, equities is not for me type of an attitude. So all those things creep in. Mm. And that is a very conventional way of looking at it. But what you rightly said is the outlier situation.
Absolutely.
And that is a situation which is a challenge for all of us. And we don't realize it. In fact, it's not as rosy as it looks. Mm. The financial planning books might say that you plan for it in XYZ. But life suddenly changes the whole equation.
Oh, absolutely. And even before we get to those outlier situations, I think it's important to understand that the cost of living itself in big metro cities in this country, I don't know if a pure debt investment, plain vanilla fixed deposits are going to do you justice for the 20 years that, let's say, you'll have after you turn 60. So let's start with this. Before we get to some of these exceptional situations that may arise once you've crossed 60, let's look at the basics. Without even considering some of these outlier situations like a family emergency or a health situation, if we're talking just planning for 20 years, supposedly, if life expectancy takes us till 80, 60 to 80, that's 20 years that you need to plan for. The numbers, how do they stack up? When does one begin? I mean, what should the goal be?
Okay, so on the point of conventional, it's a very good equation and simple equation here.
Okay.
The outlier situation does not come in yet.
Hmm.
So say hypothetically a person who's 30, who's more or less now settled down in life, now starts planning for his retirement.
Hmm.
And we start with the basis that his present expenses have to be taken into perspective.
Sure.
So obviously by that age he's married and in a urban class of working, he has an expense of 75,000 rupees.
Per month?
Per month.
Okay.
And you assume a 6% inflation going forward as a benchmark to be assumed. Now, that could go up and down, but we calculate at 6%. Now, that same 75,000, over a period of 30 years, that's when he hits retirement.
Mm-hmm.
The per month expense, if you were to look at it, could be looking at, you know, something like 4,30,000.
That would be the monthly expense.
Monthly expense.
30 years down the line, if you're spending, so basically what you're saying is if you're spending 75,000 rupees a month today, 30 years down the line when you're retiring, that number is going to compound.
Compound to 4,30,000.
4,30,000. That's going to be the monthly requirement.
Yeah, but that's the first part of the equation. Now, that's when you stop earning and you only have to meet that expense post-retirement.
Yeah.
So that's when your life expectancy seeps in.
Mm.
And you have another 20 years, God willing, so to have projected for those expenses.
So I'd be very worried if I'm living another 20 years with that kind of financial requirement. And if I haven't planned for it, absolutely. Yeah.
So the point is that that also will be against an inflated value.
Hmm.
But also you will be investing also for it.
Sure.
So you come at a real rate of return.
Okay.
So which is investment minus the inflation.
Okay.
So at the age of 60, you should be ready to face those next 20 years with a corpus of, you know, it sounds alarming, but 6 crore 20 lakh.
So 6 crores, 20 lakhs. That's what I need to retire.
Yeah.
Clearly, I'm not retiring anytime soon.
Exactly. So now that looks a big figure. But the good part you have it in your favor working right now is you've got a decent 30 years to make that money.
Okay.
Now, again, as financial planners, we work on assumptions and figures for the moment to at least set a roadmap. And we say that we have an investment of, say, 12% moderate returns.
Okay.
A 12% CAGR.
Okay.
So to reach that corpus of 6 crore 20, if you break down that amount, it comes to a monthly investment. You call it an SIP or whatever it is.
Equity investment.
Equity investments. Yeah. You need to invest an amount of, say, 18,000 rupees per month, which is very doable.
That's not such a bad situation to be in then. Yeah.
So that's the power of compounding. And the bottom line is starting early.
And you've assumed a CAGR rate of 12%.
12%, which is very reasonable. So it's neither a very flamboyant 15-16%, nor is it the very conservative, just an FD beating type of a return. So we're somewhere in between. So this is the figure which you should be looking at.
And obviously not touching those investments, and that becomes this 18,000 rupees per month, or 20,000 if we stretch it a little bit, becomes your retirement investment, and that is not to be dipped into for a holiday, for some other, you know, expense, or, you know, buying a fancy car.
And let's stress on the point, it's a retirement thing, because there are other goals in life also.
Absolutely. So that's what I'm saying. That's that 20,000 rupee SIP, strictly retirement SIP, not to be touched. All right. So what we're going to do is take a very quick break, because this is a situation where we discussed no outlier events, just a very simplistic planning for your 20 years after you turn 60. What happens in the event when life throws a googly at you? That's what we discuss after the break.